Doctors of Reddit, what is something that you wish everyone knew about their body? Ejaculating blood happens to most people at least once in their lives, and in 99% of cases it resolves without taking any action within a week. It doesn't even warrant a doctor visit. Peeing blood, for both sexes, is a serious medical emergency and you should immediately go to the ER. People think it's the other way around. If you could keep track of the assorted parts you've had removed or added, that'd be very helpful. I'm not saying you need to know whether your fund application was in a sonorador, but if you're complaining about belly pain, it would be nice to know that the last time you had belly pain they took out your gallbladder slash appendix slash sigmoid colon. And if you've ever had something implanted and they gave you a little card, that's not warranty information. That tells us if you're going to explode if you go in an MRI. Bring it. Otherwise it will be googled. That there is a wide range of normal. Don't be embarrassed by your body. Having said that, if you are concerned about anything, ask your doctor. We have generally heard it all before. And trust me, we have, nearly always, seen it all before. Maybe you have something that has been bothering you for ages, but you were too scared or embarrassed to ask about it. Just ask. It might be nothing, and you have been stressing about it for no reason. And if not, then you are at least one step closer to getting it fixed. No one can help if they don't know. There are no stupid questions, so ask away. I'm always amazed when I have been asked about something that has been bothering a patient for years and years, but they were too embarrassed slash scared to bring it up. Most of the time, it is nothing slash a completely normal body function slash feature. Other times, it is something that should have been discussed right away. You know your body best. So speak up. Don't wait for the doctor to ask the right question. I think there are a lot of obvious ones, like how lifestyle choices in your 20s impact your health and quality of life in your 40s. It would help if more patients knew their family history, though not everyone has this opportunity unfortunately. Prevention is becoming more and more important in medicine, and treating a disease in its early stages is a lot better than catching it late. If you have family members who had ovarian or colon cancer in their 30s, that is very significant for your own risk. The screening and tests we run might change, depending. If you want to start the pill, it's important to know about breast cancer, DVTs, clotting disorders in the family. If you're a bit overweight and have no metabolic syndrome problems in the family, compared to a bit overweight but both your parents have type 2 diabetes and cardiovascular disease, the management priorities change. Asking your family about any recurring diseases or diseases that occurred early, 20s, 30s, maybe 40s, can be helpful. There are certain common conditions that are underdiagnosed but easily fixed. Even if you have non-specific symptoms, it doesn't hurt to tell your doctor during the next visit. About 5% of US adults have an iron deficiency which can cause loss of concentration and fatigue, and a huge amount are vitamin D deficient. When I'm able to complete a systems review, ask screening questions about every different body system, I end up discovering a lot of irritable bowel syndrome, hyperthyroidism, insomnia, joint pain, headaches, etc. that impact quality of life. But people don't bring it up because they don't want to be a bother or think the symptoms are too vague. It's not a bother, and often, but not always, these conditions have simple treatments which can really improve how you feel. Some people seem to think that if you act healthy for a bit, it'll make up for being a wreck. There are so many things wrong with this. Just one example, antioxidants are like gas for your car. You can store up a certain amount of vitamins, but your tank can only hold so much. If you binge and overfill your tank, it doesn't do anything. You excrete it out as waste, and you can't expect to go the next several months without gas, just because you tried to overload it before. You're going to still need to get gas. Same goes for your fruits and veggies. Had someone tell me he went vegetarian for a few weeks, which meant he was done for the year. He was dead serious. Had a patient at risk for heart failure try to insist that if she stayed away from salt entirely for X days slash weeks, She should be able to have her fill of McDonald's fries and ramen. Had a smoker argue that, if he stopped for some time, he should be able to smoke freely for a while. With some digging, stopping turned out to mean a couple less cigarettes a day. My phone is acting up, so if this has already been posted I apologize, but women, please do not use soap or douching products inside your vagina. It has a delicate pH balance and this is how you get yeast infections. Wash your labia, but do not clean internally. The vagina is self-cleaning just like your eyeballs. Do you wash your eyeballs? No. Do you wash your face? Yes. The vagina is self-cleaning, just like your eyeballs. Do you wash your eyeballs? No. This is a great way to explain it. Tell us what drugs and alcohol you're on. We aren't gonna tell the cops. We aren't gonna lecture you. But it might change the anesthesia I give you. Some stuff I give you might kill you. If you drink a 30 pack a day, tell me. Your kidneys and liver cheerfully do all the toxin elimination you'll ever need. Cleanses and other detoxifying products are bullshit woo, and a waste of money. The people who sell them are predators who only care about your money becoming thys. Type 2 diabetes is more serious than most people realize. I work as a doctor in hemodialysis and most of them are due to diabetic nephropathy. It also affects your eyes, nerves, immune system, etc. Simple life changes can help you, but no one seems to care. I even lost 9 kilograms myself, because I had a family history of diabetes and to be healthy. Edit. Wow, thanks for the silver, stranger. I didn't expect this comment to be big, but please take care of yourselves, people, because it is really sad for us doctors to see people get ill because of a preventable illness. Also, there are lots of good subreddits for people trying to make a lifestyle change. You and your body deserve better. Edit 2. Change diabetes to type 2 diabetes for clarification. Changed easy to simple. Diabetic here. So much this. I'm trying to do my best by carb counting, checking my levels 8 to 10 times a day, setting the diabetes team next week to try and get approval for a pump and/or CGM. I was diagnosed 23 months ago after severe acute pancreatitis, which destroyed my pancreas and nearly killed me. Diabetes complications scare me. Amputations, blindness, and kidney failure are bad news. But it's DKA that really scares me. You need some kind of exercise. Doesn't matter how you feel right now, sitting for 12 to 16 hours a day will have negative consequences. I got a new job since last November that has me on my feet for around 6 hours a day minimum. After years of desk work, I'm down 2 holes on my belt since. I did the same thing. I wasn't fat, but I was getting tubby and weak from working at a computer. My face was fat, even. Pay cut, on my feet 10 hours, do a lot of laboring here and there, work with and around a lot of interesting, funny people, exercise after work now too. Never been happier, or in better shape. Nothing gets to me at the moment. I feel like being physically busy all the time has done something to my entire self. You only get one body. The way you treat it has a significantly higher impact on how your health will end up in a decade than what sort of interventions we can give you. You really should treat your body like a temple. Edit. It's a saying, yao. If you want, treat it like a family heirloom, bonsai, or your favorite china. Edit 2. The original question is asking what I wished more people knew about their body. I answered this by saying I wish they would do more to do more self-care, advice that is easier said than done. This means keeping up with mental and physical health, eating well, exercising, and not utilizing tobacco/nicotine, drinking to an excess, or other substances. I'm in no way advocating for avoiding the use of prescribed medicines or advice given to you by your own primary care provider. This one is more about medication. Antibiotics only work against bacteria. They are not some kind of wonder potion that cures anything, and they should not always be given. Please stick to your prescription the doctor gives you. Even if you already feel better, don't just stop unless the doctor says you can stop. A lot of medication needs to be taken according to the prescription in order for it to be effective. because you build up the DOSes to an effective level. Stopping or not sticking to it really decreases effectivity. Take care of your kidney. If your renal function is shot, it closes the door on so many options. Edit. A lot of people asked about how to take care of your kidneys. I suppose this just shows that we need to learn to take care of all parts of our body more. The most important thing is to care for your cardiovascular health. Healthy arteries and healthy kidneys are strongly correlated. For most Americans, this would require an adjustment to their diet and lifestyle. Most people would also do well to increase water consumption and reduce salt intake. If you have diabetes or SLA, your kidney health pretty much determines your expectancy, so have a conversation with your doctor. Other than this, regular self-examination and health examinations can be very beneficial. Changes in urinary patterns? Bubbles in your urine that won't pop? Does your urine smell sweet? Talk to your family physician. Do you have a family history of PCKD or whatnot? Think about getting regular ultrasound examinations of your kidney every few years. Thanks for watching the freshest content from r/AskReddit. Be sure to return to see more and sub PLS.